Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for another Wacky Wednesday. I can't keep doing this voice here on the channel. Today, we're going to be playing as regular Apollyon, or Apollyon, however you want to pronounce his name. A lot of people are requesting him, and it has been a while since we actually played as Apollyon, so I figured, why not? You know, we've had a lot of really good and fun discussions about Void and the Bag of Crafting lately, and it's just been a while. So, and again, thank you all very much for making this happen, because we did have another like streak video get tallied down below. As you see here, 196 out of 210. We had another one cross 5,000 likes, thanks to everybody and their vigilance and also dedication and support. I really do appreciate it, everyone. Hope you had a great start to your Wednesday here in the Mosh Pit. Here's your meme of the day. This one brought to you by DeadK7. Title thread was, let's go fight the boss. It's going to be Limehorn. This is like, we did have like a kind of a similar one like a year ago or something like that, where someone just replaced Littlehorn's head with a lime. So I like that this one's just gone full-blown insanity and replaced every part of him with a lime. So thank you very much, DeadK7 and all 339 of you who upvoted that one. Lots of upvotes today. Oh, man. C-Day is going to be 07 Papa Hotel, Foxtrot 4, Romeo Sierra. We've got base Apollyon stats. And we also have Bird's Eye, which is a result of us getting Eden's Blessing yesterday. That crazy run, that was whatever that was. But yeah, I've been having a lot of fun, you know, talking about Void, and you know, Void in general is still a good item because it allows you to get something for nothing. You see here the Flame proc from Bird's Eye, which is very, very strong, especially if you end up getting like a high luck rating, and if you also have a very high fire rate, which right now. Right now, base Apollyon does not have a really good fire. It's not terrible. Like, it's 2.73, which is actually higher on the base level for a tiers rate. What was that? Wow. That was some insane acceleration there. Anyway, also starting with zero luck rating, so we need to bring that up a little bit more just so we can get a little bit more consistent procs off of Bird's Eye. And if you don't know what Void does, by the way, Void will basically take any passive item and turn it into a stat or a couple stats. If you're lucky enough, it would turn it to like one of the premier stats that you really, really, really want. Wow, this is tempting here with having the coupon with Void. Would be pretty nice. So what we could do is we could theoretically do this. Okay, we got the sack here for free. I'm going to buy the battery. We could have just taken restock at this point, but now I'm determined. Okay, that's not what I wanted. So we still have that mini charge there, and then it's a 50-50 whether or not we get restock or the soul heart for free, or we can just simply buy the soul heart and guarantee that we get restock for free. Restock, I mean, like, is not that great anymore. Obviously, we don't really care too much about, you know, being able to buy consistently from the store because the prices keep rising and rising and rising. I know I'm not just talking about gas prices. But yeah, restock is not like a premier we just gotta get this. Actually, now that I think about it, we can't get restock because Void, the way that Void works now, it doesn't work off of active items immediately. You have to get another full charge on it, so we actually can't get restock unless we somehow get Pageant Boy or something here, which should not be a boss item at all, by the way. I just want to point that out. Unless it guaranteed like 25 cents or something. We do get eye drops, which is a pretty decent tiers up here. Gives us a chance to fire an extra shot out of our other eye. Yeah, so we cannot get coupon. We can void coupon, but it's not going to activate this time around. Take that. And again, the us not being able to get restock is not that big of a deal. I'm actually not going to buy the soul heart in a shocking move, I know. Shocking move, but I'm not going to buy the soul heart. I'm going to save the 5 cents in case we do need a full charge on the next floor. I'm confident with us having Bird's Eye that we're going to be just fine. Having Void here will, again, it would give us the opportunity to gain something for nothing for passive items that we don't really want or that are just bad. Or, like, you know, we can actually do something with those HP upgrades that, like, we see all too many of. Burning Cloudy has become more burninger now. Thank you. Not going to go in the curse room right now. We want to protect our Devil Deal chance as much as possible. There we go. What I'm encouraged about with us having Bird's Eye as well here in this run is the fact that because Void can give us a luck upgrade by consuming passive pedestal items, that increases our chance of possibly proccing Bird's Eye a whole lot more than we usually would for the most part anyway. No. Although with Soy Milk and Bird's Eye would proc a lot more, and I think that Bird's Eye is actually, I think it has its own flat stats. I think. Yeah, it's pure Spitfire right now. Why not? It's wacky. It's Wednesday. We've got Void, so I'm hoping that we can at least get some kind of damage upgrade out of this. We'll see. Okay, yeah. So it actually doesn't have its own damage stat, because a regular Bird's Eye shot would have just destroyed all of those flies here. But like I said, with Void, we might be able to feed ourselves some good damage upgrades. Even though the Soy Milk coefficient is going to be active for any damage upgrades we get, still, minimal damage upgrades is better than no damage upgrades. I mean, we're still dealing damage as well as removing projectiles with Bird's Eye, so, you know, it's not a horrible decision to take Soy Milk, but it just usually is. Just leave little fires here and there. Synth oil, absolutely want the damage up. Dark Prince's Crown. I mean, I'll take it just to have a Devil Deal. But like, we're not gonna do anything with it. We'll take the Devil Deal precedence. I have one key, so I'm not really going to make that happen. Again, Synth Oil was a big damage up for us here, bringing our damage up to over one, which may seem kind of irrelevant, but you just got to remember how much of a huge penalty it is for having Soy Milk. And any damage up that we get is going to be a significant DPS up, and that's the biggest thing when it comes to Soy Milk. You're looking, it's all about DPS. So, and the higher their base damage goes, the better that Bird's Eye gets. Now that I know that it's not off of a flat damage rate. And I mean, Dark Prince's Crown, if it does activate, you know, that could potentially get us, you know, more tiers than we would originally have. So, you know, you never know. There we go. Got our full charge back. And there's the east side of the map now. Yabe, so we could potentially do this mob trap room if we really, really wanted to. There we go. It's always a good feeling when you see all the Bird's Eye fires kind of like just pile in. There we go. That was my fault. The double fly below me caused me to look at that instead of trying to dodge the green flies that we had split open. We basically split the line in two there. And that's what I should have been focusing on instead of the immortal double flies. Still looking for our item room. Found everything else but that. As you do. So we get the bonus from destroying the keeper despite not having to use a bomb, which is kind of nice. But we still want to find our item room. There it is. Secret room's going to be actually below here. I think. Okay, money equals power, which I will take. It's not going to be a significant damage up right now, but potentially it could be later. It really depends on if... It depends on how often that we're spending our money, you know, so we may want to go back and do that mob trap room to get some possible money out of there. Money equals power is going to increase our damage based on how many coins we're holding on to. Every time we pick up a coin, it's going to increase our damage by a little bit, but it adds up. So as you see there, it just barely registered. Went from 1.23 to 1.24. And I gotta say, I'm loving this sort of Spitfire build that we've got. I wasn't too sure about it after I found out that Birdseye doesn't scale with your... It doesn't have its own flat damage, but this is working. This is working. And the fact that the red candle fires still stay on the floor is really good. I'm gonna avoid this, and we do get a damage upgrade and a movement speed upgrade as well, so I'm super duper happy about that. Grab the full charges here. We are sacrificing a little bit of our chances of getting boss rush, but I do want to do this mob trap room. Well, got a bomb out of it, but it could have been a lot better. But taking old bandage, I mean, old bandage is good, don't get me wrong, especially with us having money equals power. If we find like a temperance machine or if we find the IV bag, you know, potentially could be more damage, more valuable there, but for right now, for the immediate needs, you know, a 0.2 damage upgrade is huge for soy milk. So we wasted about 30 seconds there, but I think it was worth it. Super secret room. Can't be there. Yeah, whatever. We gotta get a move on. We want to avoid that boss rush. Alright, 68% deal with the devil chance now. Soy milk tears are starting to turn. We're starting to get to the, like, the golf ball size. We're not exactly volleyball size yet, but we're getting there. Mom's bracelet we do not want. And honestly, I'm not even tempted to even pick up this this tarot card here. Super secret room is going to give us two keys, which is something that we definitely needed. Get a 0.05 damage upgrade there with that one singular nickel. Yeah, this is a good room here. Two soul hearts, we get three bombs. We get two bombs for the price of one, essentially. I don't know where our item room is. These item rooms have been showing up in weird places lately. Yeah, this is where, like, this build really thrives. The little tiny leaper spiders there, the eggles. And yeah, there's the northeast side of the map as we continue to look for just our item room. So lots of backtracking is the name of the game. All right. We could and should open one of those golden chests, but you never know if we're going to need the bombs. You never know if we're going to need the keys. We might need a bomb here for this curse room. More happily inclined to go into a curse room or going after a golden chest here that probably is going to give us nothing. Now, I've been hit by mega troll bombs with radiuses far greater than that. That bomb should have hit that stone chest. I'm just saying, game. Nod leaf? No. Okay, so we end up getting a range upgrade and a shot speed upgrade there. So hopefully we get a key out of this chest right here. Or we get an Emperor card. I mean, Emperor card's fine. It's not what I really needed right now, but, you know, if it comes down to it, you know, we could use it for boss rush. There we go. And again, even these 1/100ths of a point of damage, they're going to make a difference when you've got soy milk. You got to remember the sheer amount of shots that we're firing out. Any increase in damage is good enough for me there. Wow, that is the first time I've ever seen Forsaken do that, and that's a 73% deal with the devil fail. Woo! Womp, 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 womp. All right, here we go with another 4/5 devil deal. Neat. Real neat. You get some Yaves here. And you're seeing here that despite the fires being pretty small in size, we're still able to not only beat back the egglets or eggles, but also take down pretty much every single projectile that the greed heads were trying to fire at us. Okay, well, here's the boss. Be Fallen. All right, Fallen, you have a chance to make things right here. I'll take Twisted Pear. No. Those are super secret room. Twisted Pear with this build here, I don't know if they... I'm not sure if they actually fire... I don't think they fire actual fire like we do. Does that make sense? Like, they don't get the bird's eye effect like we do here. But still, having an additional source of, like, this many projectiles is going to be just massive for us. Get another 0.2 move or 0.2 damage upgrade, and another range upgrade as well. So we've now almost brought our damage total up to 2, which is really, really solid for Apollyon. Apollyon. However Matthias says it. I still say Apollyon, but I guess, like, phonetically speaking, like a pole, like a APOLL would be a poll, so sure. We'll go with it. We have been making some new tracks. We've just added 2 new songs to our repertoire. That's a collaborative effort of Planet Ridiculon and Word of Lauder, our collab. As you didn't know, we've formed a band, a totally original group comprised of myself, my bandmate Mark from Word of Water, and then the members of Planet Ridiculon, which include Matthias Bossy and John as well. So we've got a quad of really talented people making some awesome music, and I'm looking forward to sharing it with you all eventually. I did play a little bit of a preview of it a couple weeks ago for the birthday stream. I probably wasn't supposed to do that, but I couldn't resist. The mosh pit was super duper supportive during the birthday marathon, as they always are. There you go. We're over 2 damage now. We also get a tears rate upgrade. Yikes. That is quite a bit of tears upgrade, I gotta say. 23.5 shots per second. Dealing 2.18 damage per shot. That is really, really solid. And remember, the stronger that our base damage gets, the better that our bird's eye damage is too. So, you know, all systems are go here for the soy milk build. Grab this, increasing a little bit of our damage. Yeah, money equals power is just one of those items that will always just be good. Just say it's an evergreen item. I'm actually not going to buy anything because of that reason. I want to make sure that we're maintaining this good damage here. So we get a hermit card, which I'm not going to pay attention to. Yeah, mom is not going to have a good time here. And we'll be able to burn down all of her adds and their projectiles pretty quickly. Yeah, this is exactly the reason why I wanted to pick up soy milk. Even with Birdseye not doing a flat amount of damage like I thought it did, it's still doing some work here. We even get lump of coal. Oh my goodness. It's about to get crazy, y'all. We could void this. Eden's Blessing. I think this only voids one. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that only voided one of them. But my goodness, the adding of lump of coal to this build is brutal because it scales so quickly. By the time that it hits like our enemy, like we're dealing like double the amount of damage that we normally would. So we're doing lots of good stuff here. Lots of quality stuff. We do have our Emperor card here, so. Yeah, you're about to see the pain factor go up a whole lot with Lump of Coal. Wow. Look at that. I mean, this damage is... It's gonna get nutty, y'all. Further away we are from a target, the better. I'm not taking the horse pill because we really don't need to worry about pills on a run like this because we've got void. We got another Yave here. That was kind of weird. It was almost like we went through that rock. Oh, I thought Lust was gonna die by then. We just need something like Jacob's Ladder, and we are set. Yeah, that is a respectable amount of damage here. Okay, and this is another respectable dead end. All right. There's the southwestern side of the map. Let's go check out the southern side before we ultimately have to realize that we're going to have to go north. Secret rooms to the right of here. There's a tinted rock in here. There's a tinted rock in my boot. Oh my goodness. Too bad we can't take it. Yeah, there's no way that we can get this without flying. So hopefully we find like a hangman card or something because sacred orb would be sacred nice. Especially if we're going to do a victory lap, which is Looking like we're going to right now. Taking the negative did also give us a damage upgrade, and yeah, there we go. All right, Bonafide Genuine Premium Gourmet Disney Plus level style Sinvicta Full Clear at your service. There we go. All right. How does he do it? Scientifically and mathematically impossible, people have been saying. But yet, this man does it every single day. Defying math and science and logic, one video at a time. Should be on a t-shirt, really. Black tooth, I mean, might as well take it. We're going to be firing lots of teeth here. Hey, look at that. We almost completely shut down Polycephalus' attack just by attacking him. So there you go. So those of you playing along at home, there's the entire map. Brought to you by yours truly. Happy to be of service. We get lump. We get a cube of meat, which I will definitely void. Also activated our Dark Prince's crown here. We did get another damage upgrade. And yeah, we cannot get Sacred Orb, unfortunately. I'd love to void it though, but I don't think we're gonna have enough charges. Yep, not gonna happen. So a little bit of a sad face there, but what can you do? What can you really do? Oh my goodness, look at this tears right now. 34 and a half. Thanks to Dark Prince's Crown. We've got lots and lots and lots and lots of damage that we're pumping out here. It's not quite shutdown damage, like we can just turn off our brain and talk about, like, you know, movies and stuff, but we're almost there. Buttless Chub. She ain't got no butt. Sometimes there's a secret, sometimes not a secret room, but a tinted rock in that room. Secret room should be here. And it is. I gotta say, money equals power. I'm glad that we've resisted spending any of it. Not that we've had, like, great shops anyway on this run, but you know, having that bonus really stack up, especially with the scaling of Lump of Coal, is just, it's just brutality. We'll give ourselves. We could play the Bomb Beggar in hopes of getting another item pedestal to void, but. Oh man, look at that damage. We do get a devil deal here. Flying, it would have been useful. I mean, Death's List. We do need movement speed really bad. Death's List is going to be really hard to do. Honestly, I'm confident enough, even with this amount of HP, with this damage. Get a lap one old Hushy kill. Old Hushy. And look at that, we get a strength card, so we can use that against old Hushy, since we don't have to worry about... for better or for worse, we don't have to worry about us not having the Polaroid. Oh, man. Euthanasia with this. This is getting out of control in a hurry here. Wouldn't mind Sharp Straw, to be honest, but our base damage is so low. Okay, so I think we voided Sharp Straw there instead of Bomber Boy. Damage now sitting at 2.82. And imagine if we can get to 3 damage. Stopwatch It is going to help us out with Hushy. But at the same time, I'd rather have our damage bonus, to be honest. I honestly think our damage bonus is more important than having stopwatch. Yeah. Look at that stream of just death right there. This is with Hush not even in the fire that we're setting yet. And this is precisely why I wanted soy milk, because we had Bird's Eye. Because we can sit there and we can just sit there and go toe to toe with Hush and not have to worry too much about his projectiles. At the very least, we get to greatly reduce the amount of projectiles that he's sending at us, and that is in and of itself a very good defensive maneuver. I did not know he was doing continuum here. Constant fire here. As long as we can intercept the continuum tiers, we don't have to worry about dodging them. There we go. A little bit hairy there. We got hit, I think, 3 times, so we need to be a little bit careful. I will buy this half-price soul heart just because. And yeah, down we go. So we lose our massive tears up there because of the fact that we don't have Dark Prince's Crown active anymore. But still. And then this is, of course, going to be, another one of those runs. Oh, my goodness. Yeah, that increases our tears by 5.5. Wowee. It's going to be another one of those runs where the Emperor card is going to be instrumental in keeping us safe. Look at that. We can actually, because we have Euthanasia, we're actually able to take down the statues as well. Just by simply shooting at them. Now, if we end up having, I wish we had Sulfuric Acid so we could take down, like, obstacles in front of us, too. Yeah, so there's an almost full clear shoal. Got the jar of lemonade there just because. I don't know if it actually affects Stanley or not, but I can pretend it does. I know it's gonna hit his feet. Yeah. That is some impressive DPS that we've got right now. And it's only going to get better if on this victory lap here. Central Spirit, little Abba Dabba Ding Dong, Spectral Tears. Yeah, these are very good. Emperor card, take us home for a solid Repentance Soy Milk run. You know, I got to give the co-MVP. Co-MVP goes to Bird's Eye and Soy Milk, obviously. They're working in tandem together, so this is just domination. Second seed, Golf Sierra Mike 6, Sierra 218. Now, obviously, we also have to give an extra special shout-out to Eden's Blessing from yesterday's run, because we wouldn't have had Bird's Eye in the first place, which probably would have stopped me from taking Soy Milk. I'm going to be honest. But the last couple times that we had Soy Milk and Repentance has actually not been all that bad, unlike Jawbone. Not a fan of Jawbone. Not a fan. Now, Vet Curse the Unknowns quite a bit. Got a movement speed upgrade. I'm honestly fine with that. We also finally get a luck upgrade. Actually, our first luck upgrade that we've ever gotten on this run. So, yeah, I'm cool with that. More fire, more euthanasia shots, the better. Now, we could reroll a little bit here. I'm not totally against the idea. Just remember that every time that we spend a... there we go. That's all I wanted. Every time that we spend money, we're dropping our damage by a significant amount here. But we're about to get most of that back, so hopefully anyway. And again, on a run like this where we have soy milk, we want to try to keep as much damage as possible. And this cardio coin is just doing it for me. We actually gained damage off of that. My God. We'll take the 4 soul hearts here. As this victory lap is... going to be brutal. I'm hoping that we get some pretty interesting tier effects or something. Get a library. Get one of them there libraries. We're almost maxed out on money equals power now. Devil card. Not sure which one we voided, but I'm sure we'll find out eventually. Hopefully Book of Sin, and there's our money maxed out now. Wafer, we gotta take Wafer. Wafer is way too good not to not to void. M, I mean, we could take M. I think this is one of those rare occasions where I don't really want to, just because we're kind of, you know, we're having a good time with Void. Void's been doing awesome. And again, the potential there for luck, the potential there for damage upgrades is still going to be important. I would take mapping if we could get it for sure. Tears up. I think it still does add to it, yeah. And there's 9 lives. We already have Gimpy, so I'm not going to worry about that. Oh, my goodness. And remember, we've got Dark Prince's Crown, too. 44.74. We're moving into Ultra Soy Milk territory now. Global D Twanky is going to give us our money back here. We have nearly tripled our original starting. Actually, we have tripled because we were at like 18, something like that. And now we're kind of in like domination, shut off the brain. We can start talking about, you know, start talking about movies and whatnot. We did get, actually, the Book of Sin, too, so 2.75 damage up. Or, tears up, I mean. Good lordy. Got some super soy milk now. I mean, it's just instant activation for any tier effect that we have that's luck based. I mean, that was right there. That was 4 euthanasia shots. Like, we got it going on here in this run. There we go. We don't have to worry about money anymore, obviously, because we've got 99 cents. Stained is going to be just a little stain on the ground here in a second. Down he goes. We get marbles, which I wouldn't I wouldn't actually mind, but we also get some Victor robes, which does it does destroy our tears rate again, since we don't have the activation of Dark Prince's crown, but definitely worth it for the damage up. We're now over 3. And now we're getting to the point where, like, nothing is going to be able to stop us. Looking for Magic Mush one time? All right. This is worth a shot. I mean, this is like, before things can even react, they're dead. Definitely take the double soul hearts here. Probably should have avoided Lash Key, but it would give us... It does give us another luck upgrade, which is the main reason why I decided to take it. We have not seen the item room or the store, which means that they are... adjacent from one another! Oh my god. I think we shot nothing but euthanasia shots in the Zubat room. That was incredible. We get another fire rate up here. Our base tears rate is now 39.24. Mama Mega. Ace of Spades, no thank you. That is just... And the fact that we're maintaining over 3 damage rating on our base damage here with soy milk is just... that's just stupid amounts of damage that we're doing. This isn't even our final form. Wait till we end up getting our HP upgrade back and activating Dark Prince's crown. Yeah, good luck. Carrion Queen, she didn't even make it to the opposite wall. Yeah, I mean, might as well take some more tears up. Base stat is now 45.1. This is built off of just the simple strength of soy milk. We're still getting these crazy tears ups. It's really, really impressive. So here's my apology to soy milk every time we pass it up in repentance here, because man, you've got potential for some pretty incredible synergies. Guppy's head is going to be our second Guppy item. Seagrim might be here. It is. I just imagine had we gotten Sacred Orb, that would have been real nice. I think I might have to go get myself a Subway sandwich after this. I'm kind of hungry. What's your go-to sandwich from Subway? Those of you who do decide to go take the plunge to the sub. My go-to is usually like tuna. I just like Subway tuna is not too bad. If I'm really, really hungry, like I'll go for like a chicken bacon ranch. Bubby, no thank you. Eden's Blessing. Sure, we'll take it. We'll add on more to our tears rate. I had chicken earlier today, so I may not do a chicken bacon ranch, although it does sound pretty tasty. Occasionally, like if I just feel super lazy, but like I just want to be like really basic, like I'll go for a turkey ham and cheese. I haven't had one of those in a while. Maybe we'll do that. I didn't notice that was a haunted chest until it was too late, unfortunately. Again, this is another reason why we stick to Void here, because if we do get screwed and get some suboptimal boss drops here, we can still turn them into something, like turning it into a 0.2 damage upgrade. Man. You gotta get the baked barbecue Lays though. Like I like regular barbecued Lays potato chips for sure, but for some reason, like when I see them in when I go to Subway, like I always go for the baked Lays. They're so good. Not as greasy. They have a nice baked flavor. I mean, yeah, we can take the blanket. We can see what happens when we drop our damage down by a lot. Yeah, so we lost 0.19 damage, and we're still over 3. So I don't even worry. I don't even care about the Fool card right now, because we can just simply destroy everything. Or we can go fight Old Beastie as well. Old Beastie would be hilarious to fight with this build. We would also be able to see what this could do against Dogma. Yeah, we can just fire. It's so freeing and liberating to be able to just fire at like skulls and like the Mask of Infamy. We have 52.25 shots per second now. That's a lot of attacks. Like a lot. So let's see what Mom's gonna be able to do, which is not gonna be much. And we weren't even getting the full spread of damage there because we weren't able to activate Lump of Coal. Oh my god. Sure, why not? Alright. Alright. This is we're getting a little spicy. A little spicy. Nothing incredible, you know. Just having a good time playing some Binding of Isaac Repentance. Absolutely crushing everything in the seed. Definitely, if you want a crazy good soy milk. I mean, now obviously you're not going to have unless you get extremely lucky and you just happen to have gotten Eden's Blessing. You're not going to get Bird's Eye, but even without Bird's Eye, like we'd still be very, very powerful. not as powerful, but almost as powerful. Yeah, you do not want to be on the receiving end of this cricket's body shot. So, like, the targets in front of us are not having a good time, but the targets that are in that area right there, that you see everything kind of splashing in, yeah, that's the kill. That's the ultimate kill zone right there. Stigmata. I will take Stigmata because it does activate our Dark Prince's Crown. And why not just have 66 tiers per second? You know? Why not? In this economy? Sure. We can do it. I will go check to see if we can get Guppy here. Okay. There goes the Polaroid. We don't need it. I think we'll be fine. Remember, this is with us not having maxed out Money Equals Power again. So we have the Devil card, we can save that for Old Beastie, or we can use it for Dogma. Doesn't really matter. Yep, we'll just destroy everything. Who cares about Brimstone turrets when you've got the... Oh my goodness. We got the ability to just kill everything in the room with Euthanasia. So we're actually finally capped on tiers now. That's the reason why the screw didn't do anything. And there's our Money Equals Power back booster here. And what's so funny, because of Cricket's body, we don't even have to directly hit something for euthanasia. We indirectly hit them thanks to Cricket's body. And away we go.
I spent it. It's gone. Just get over it.
I mean, it's gone. How can you have spent our savings?
Ares are a little chubby. More shot speed upgrade. We'll do that. And we got a full charge anyway, thanks to the Book of Sin. It would be nice if we could gain access back to that secret room that had Sacred Orb in it, but that is not going to happen here. Which is fine. I don't think it's going to matter at the end of the day anyway, obviously, because we're just going to destroy everyone. We could go get the inner child with that key piece, but again, don't really think we need to. Now, what would have really been crazy is had we gotten Guppy on this run. I mean, I guess technically there's still a chance we could get Guppy. Highly unlikely, but there's still a chance.
You need to repent. You need to confess your sins and become saved. Let his light inside you cleanse
you. And you see here, we don't have to even fire at something in a room. They just die from the residual splash damage. The procs of euthanasia from Cricket's body. So this is just a garden hose of death here. Look at that.
Where are you going? Wait, we need you. Your son needs you.
Up we go to Dogma. Now, I'm not going to lie. Dogma, it's not going to look good for you. I think that we're probably going to dominate Dogma, like, even more. Yeah, we added 0.2 more damage on there. Good lord. 3.5 damage with 66 attacks per second. Yeah. Dogma's gonna be dead in a second. I'm not even gonna bother trying to move for that because it honestly doesn't matter. And I don't think Dogma should be able to be phased through the wall because it's feared, but it doesn't matter. Really does not matter. But what does matter is those of you who do click the like button, leave a comment down below. Ultimately, I don't know what our final damage is going to be here because we can't see it, but with the Devil card, Dark Prince's Crown, our DPS is probably through the roof. Look at our range too. Yeah. Yeah. So, yeah. Thank you for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed this incredible run that we had here. Shout out to Soy Milk for sure. Soy Milk made this happen. More so Soy Milk than anything, I would say. And definitely give these two seeds a run for yourself here if you want to have just a whole lot of blasted fun and goodness. Death was really the only harbinger to get any kind of attack off here, and old beastie's not going to be happy here in a second. We actually don't even have to worry about the. Oh, maybe we do. Okay, so we got to hit her in the head to get the back shots here. All right, well, we skipped phase one completely. Will she make it to the... Oh, no, she did go past one stalactite. And there you go. What a run. What an amazing soy milk run. Thank you for watching, everyone. Like I said, if you did enjoy this episode and you want to support my channel, make sure you just click that like button. And those of you who give your super thanks every single day, I do appreciate them. They help out a great deal. And, of course, leave a comment. Let me know what your favorite soy milk synergy is. Thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing, everyone. Have a great start to your midweek here in the Mosh Pit. As always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Christian Baker, Joe Thurman, Paul, Matt Long, Dante Knight 97, and Ashley Marie. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, then check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.